ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
So next thing, next concept is equivalent weight of a substance in which different elements may either undergo oxidation or reduction. So we have a substance in which two different elements, they simultaneously, they both undergo oxidations or they both undergo reduction. Then how to find the equivalent weight of that substance? So let us take iron oxalate FeCt C2O4, iron oxalate in acidic medium. So let us try to find the equivalent weight of iron oxalate, ferrous oxalate. So first we have to know the oxidation state, how it dissociates, Fe+2, and this is oxalate ion C2O4-2. This is the dissociation. FeC2O4 dissociates into Fe+2 and C2O4-2. Then both of them undergo oxidation. Let us see, Fe+2 will undergo oxidation to Fe+3. So that means it is losing how many electrons? One electron. So its n factor or valency, one mole of Fe+2 loses one mole of electron, therefore its valency is 1. Change in oxidation state, +2 to +3, or one mole of Fe+2 loses one mole of electrons, right? So here the valency factor or n factor is 1. Coming to oxalate, C2O4-2, C double bond O, O minus, C double bond O, O minus. Oxygen, carbon, two elements. Oxygen bonded to carbon, oxygen always shows -2. What about carbon? Carbon, see, there is one CC bond and three CO bonds. Because of these CO bonds, right, carbon gets partial positive charge, or you have to assume that the bonded electrons are assigned to more electronegative atom, that is oxygen. So how many such electrons are assigned? 1, 2, 3. Here anyway they will be shared equally. So for this carbon, out of the 4 bonds, 3 bonds are with oxygen, more electronegative oxygen. So 3 electrons it may lose. That is how you have to find oxidation state. So if it loses this 3, 1, 2, 3, its oxidation state will be +3. Coming to this bond, these two elements are identical, so they equally share it. So neither lose nor gain. So here oxidation state because of this bond is 0. Coming to this carbon, same story, 1, 2, 3 bonds with oxygen, 1 bond with carbon. So 3 bonds, we have to assume that it loses these 3 electrons, because of which it gains +3. You have to assign the 3 electrons to more electronegative oxygen. Right. So what happens? It changes to carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. So what is the oxidation state of carbon dioxide? This is the structure. So carbon is bonded to oxygen atoms. How many electrons it may lose? 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, its oxidation state is +4. Right? So +3 to +4. One carbon oxidation state changes from +3 to +4. But we have to find for oxalate. What is the difference? Here, the change in oxidation state. Change in oxidation state per carbon is +3 to +4, that is 1 unit increase. But we have to find for oxalate, change in oxidation state per oxalate ion. In one oxalate ion there are two such carbons, therefore for one carbon 1 unit, for two carbons it will be 2 units increase. Therefore its n factor is 2, its n factor is 2, or valency factor is 2. So equivalent weight of ferrous oxalate is molecular weight by n1 plus n2. Molecular weight by n1 is 1, n2 is 2. So this is equal to m by 3. So we'll do one more example. So molecular weight is approximately 142. So 142, it is 142 by 3. So let us consider this reaction FeS2 in the presence of oxygen, right? So it is converted to Fe2O3 and SO2. So here our aim is to find equivalent weight of FeS2. Equivalent weight of FeS2. Right, why I am taking this example? See here, iron oxidation state, here it is +2, sulfur oxidation state -2, here it is +3, here it is +4. Iron changes from +2 to +3, that is oxidation. Sulfur changes from -2 to +4, that means it also undergoes oxidation. So in one FeS2, change in oxidation state of iron is from +2 to +3, that is one unit increase. We have to find for FeS2, in FeS2 there is only one iron, so N1 is 1, there is only one iron, therefore N1 is 1. Coming to S, change in oxidation state of sulfur, see carefully, it is -2, 2, +4, that is 6 units increase, right. But in FeS2, there are two sulfurs. Change in oxidation state of sulfur in FeS2. In FeS2 there are two sulfurs, therefore 2 into 6 -2, 4, 5, 6. You will get, sorry, sulfur it is -1, S2 -2, therefore sulfur it will be -1. -1 to +4, you will get 5 units. So for two such sulfur, you will get 10 units. So here FeS2, see once again, iron is plus 2, sulfur let us assume x, 1 into +2 iron plus 2 into sulfur x equal to 0, 2 plus 2x equal to 0, 2x equal to -2, x equal to -1. So sulfur oxidation state is -1, right. So change in oxidation state of sulfur, -1 to +4, that means 5 units increase. But in one FeS2 there are two sulfurs, so change in oxidation state of sulfur in FeS2 will be 2 into 5, 10 units, because in one FeS2 there are two sulfurs. So here N2 is, so equivalent weight of FeS2 is molecular weight by N1 plus N2. Why? Because both are undergoing same change, that is oxidation. Both are undergoing oxidation. So molecular weight by 10 plus 1, that is molecular weight by 11. So 118 by 11. A few formulas. First, equivalent volume. What is how to find equivalent volume? This is the formula, 22.4 liters by N factor. So what is this? It is the volume occupied by gaseous substance at STP. Remember, at STP, because we are using the relation that one at STP, one mole occupies 22.4 liters. So volume occupied by gaseous substance at STP corresponding to its equivalent weight. At STP 1 mole occupies 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liters. 1 mole can be converted into mass. If that mass is equal to equivalent weight, then the corresponding volume we call it as equivalent volume. So, once again I am repeating, at STP 1 mole of any gas occupies 22.4 liters. Now, suppose if I take oxygen, 1 mole oxygen occupies 22.4 liters. What is its equivalent volume? What is the equivalent mass of oxygen? Already we know that 8. So, 1 mole of oxygen means 32, that is 22.4 liters. 32 grams of oxygen occupies 22.4 liters. 8 grams occupies how much volume? The volume occupied by the mass of the substance equal to its equivalent weight at STP, we call it as equivalent volume of the gas. So, 8 grams will occupy around 5.6 liters. So, how to get this 5.6? 22.4 by valency. What is the valency? Molecular weight by equivalent weight. That is nothing but n factor. Molecular weight by equivalent weight gives n factor or valency factor. That is nothing but, here you will get 4. 32 by 8 is 4. N factor is 4. So, 22.4 by 4. 211.21 is 5.6. So, equivalent volume is nothing but the volume of gaseous substance at STP, right, when its mass is equal to its equivalent mass. So, directly equivalent volume equal to 22.4 liters, whereas n factor is nothing but here valency, which is equal to molecular weight by equivalent weight. N factor equal to molecular weight by equivalent weight of the substance. Now, if you want, you can write n factor, molecular weight by equivalent weight. Next, number of moles of substance. Already we studied this, weight of substance by gram molecular weight. Number of gram equivalence. Equivalence expressed in grams becomes gram equivalence. Number of gram equivalence of substance. Weight by equivalent weight. Remember, this is fixed for a substance, but this is not fixed. This depends upon the nature of reaction. So, you have to say the reaction and you have to write the equivalent weight. So, weight by equivalent weight gives number of gram equivalence. Right. So, using this, the observation, number of gram equivalence of all reactants reacted must be equal to number of gram equivalence of each product formed. So, let us take a reaction. R gives P. R is reactant, P is product. So, applying the principle, number of gram equivalence of R must be equal to number of gram equivalence of R must be equal to number of gram equivalence of P. How do you find number of gram equivalence? Weight by equivalent weight of R must be equal to weight by equivalent weight of P. Weight by equivalent weight of R must be equal to weight by equivalent weight of P. Already you have studied how to find equivalent weight for elements, oxidizing agent, acid, base, etc. So, you can use those formulas to find equivalent weight. Experimental methods to find atomic weight of element. One is isotopic method, we have already studied. Percentage abundance, P1, percentage abundance into atomic weight of first isotope, percentage abundance of second isotope into atomic weight, like that, so on by 100. Or you can use this equation, atomic weight into specific heat of the element. This must be for solids. This method is for solids, more applicable for solid. Atomic weight of element into specific heat of the element into, sorry, equal to 6.4. This is mostly for solids. This already we know, atomic weight equal to equivalent weight into valency. Coming to vapor density of volatile chloride method, this I will like to explain. So, let us consider a metal, MCLV, M is element, M is element, this is volatile chloride. Volatile means which can be easily vaporized, which can easily go into vapor state easily. So volatile chloride, so I am considering MClV. M is element, Cl is chloride. For example, sodium chloride NaCl, calcium chloride CaCl2, like that MClV. Here 2 is the valency of calcium, 1 is the valency of sodium, V is the valency of M. So M represents symbol of element, symbol of element, Cl chloride, V valency of element, valency of element, right. Now let us try to derive this formula. Atomic weight of M, so using this equation, atomic weight of M equal to equivalent weight of M element into its valency. So equivalent weight of M, I am writing E, valency of M. I think you have understood the meaning of V, small v. Small v is the valency of M. Here 2 is the valency of calcium charge. V is the valence. If it dissociates, this is how it dissociates. M plus V, V Cl minus. So charge on the ion will be its valency. Equivalent weight of element V, valency of the element V. So this is one equation we are going to use. And atomic weight of chlorine 35.5, molecular weight of gas or volatile compound is 2 into vapor density, vapor VD means vapor density. Volatile compound gas, right. Now what is the molecular weight of MClV? This is nothing but sum of the atomic weights. How many M are present? Only one. 1 into atomic weight of M plus there are V chloride ions, V into atomic weight of Cl. So substitute, molecular weight of MClV is nothing but 2 into vapor density of MClV. 1 into atomic weight of M is M itself, or what is atomic weight of M? Equivalent weight into V. Atomic weight of M is nothing but equivalent weight of M into V, E into V, plus V into atomic weight of chlorine is 35.5. So from this we can write V equal to 2 into vapor density of MClV by equivalent weight of M plus 35.5. So these are the equations. Once you get V, what is V valency? Valency, and you know equivalent weight, you can find atomic weight. So these are the different equations which may be useful. So next one, calculation of equivalent weight of metal. So we are going to use this formula. Number of gram equivalents of metal W1, E1, W2, E2. Number of gram equivalents of reactants reacted equal to number of gram equivalents of product formed. How do you find number of gram equivalents? Weight by equivalent weight. So principle of gram equivalents. Right. So first method. In first method, metal reacts with a substance. Let us say hydrogen displacement method. So what happens in this method? Metal reacts with some substance. Metal reacts with some substance and releases hydrogen gas. Metal reacts with some substance and releases hydrogen gas. Once again, metal reacts with some substance and releases hydrogen gas. What information they will provide? Our aim is to find equivalent weight of metal. What information they will provide? Mass of metal reacted will be given. Right, weight of metal reacted will be given. This will be provided. Coming to hydrogen, its weight may be given, weight of hydrogen produced may be given, or they may give volume of hydrogen gas. So either they may give mass of hydrogen produced or volume of hydrogen produced. They can measure weight or volume. So to proceed further, we are going to use some relations. At STP, 1 mole of any gas occupies how much volume? 22.4 liters. 1 mole of hydrogen, 1 mole of hydrogen, that is nothing but how many grams? 2 grams. 2 grams of hydrogen occupies how much volume? Sorry, 22.4 liters. 1 mole of oxygen, if I take 1 mole of oxygen, that is nothing but 32 grams of oxygen, occupies how much volume? Same, 22.4 liters. 1 mole of chlorine or 71 grams of chlorine occupies 22.4 liters. This we already know, because 1 mole of any gas occupies 1 mole. How do you find number of moles? Weight by molecular weight. If n equal to 1, then weight must be equal to its molecular weight. What is the molecular weight of H2? 2 grams. What is the molecular weight of oxygen? 32. What is the molecular weight of chlorine? 71. Right. Now, we are finding equivalent weight. If 2 grams of hydrogen at STP occupies 22.4 liters, then what is the equivalent weight of hydrogen? Equivalent weight of hydrogen is 1. So if I take 1 gram of hydrogen, occupies how much volume? 1 gram of hydrogen will occupy 11.2 liters. 32 grams of oxygen occupies 22.4 liters. Then what is the equivalent weight of oxygen? 8. So if I take 8 grams of oxygen, it occupies how much volume? If 32 grams occupies 22.4 liters, 8 grams of oxygen will occupy 5.6 liters. 71 grams of chlorine occupies 22.4 liters, right? Then 35.5, the equivalent weight of chlorine is 35.5. will occupy 11.2 liters. So we are going to use these relations. I think you have understood how we arrived at this. Coming back to this, a metal reacts with a substance and liberates hydrogen gas. What information will be given? Mass of metal reacted will be given. Either mass of hydrogen produced will be given or volume of hydrogen released at STP may be given. Then how to find equivalent weight? So using this formula, I am applying for metal and I am applying for this hydrogen. So what I will get? Number of gram equivalents of metal reacted must be equal to number of gram equivalents of hydrogen produced.
So using this principle, number of gram equivalence of metal reacted must be equal to number of gram equivalence of hydrogen produced. So how do you find number of gram equivalence? Weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal. This is equal to weight of hydrogen produced or displaced or liberated by equivalent weight of hydrogen.
So instead of this, you can express in volume. If volume is given, then what happens?
Volume of hydrogen produced
at STP. Highlight once again.
Volume of hydrogen displaced at STP in liters by
equivalent weight of hydrogen. If you express this mass in volume, this must be expressed in volume at STP. What is equivalent weight of hydrogen? 1. At STP, 1 gram of hydrogen occupies how much volume? 11.2.
If I express this mass in volume, the equivalent weight must be expressed in volume. Equivalent weight of hydrogen, which is 1. At STP, 1 gram of hydrogen occupies how much volume? 11.2 liters. They must be in same units.
What we require? Equivalent weight of metal. So equivalent weight of metal is equal to, cross multiplying this, what I will get?
Weight of metal reacted by weight of hydrogen displaced into equivalent weight of hydrogen. So this is weight of metal reacted by weight of hydrogen displaced. What is the equivalent weight of hydrogen? 1.
Or if you want to write in terms of volume, we can write like this:
equivalent weight of metal.
So not writing this, just cross multiply this. What I will get? Cross multiply. I am just taking this the other side. You will get this one here.
So weight of metal reacted by volume of hydrogen displaced, hydrogen gas displaced at STP, condition supply in liters, into 11.2.
So these are the equations to find equivalent weight when weight of hydrogen displaced is given or volume of hydrogen produced at STP is given. So since hydrogen, with respect to hydrogen we are studying, we call it as hydrogen displacement method. We call it as hydrogen displacement method. Next one, oxygen displacement method. What happens? So here metal reacts with a substance and liberates oxygen gas. Metal reacts with a substance and liberates oxygen gas. Same procedure. What information they will provide? Mass of metal will be given. Mass or weight, both are same here. Mass of metal will be given. For oxygen, either mass can be given, mass of oxygen can be given, or volume of oxygen at STP in liters can be given. So either they can measure volume or mass for a gas. Any information can be provided. Applying principle of gram equivalence, number of gram equivalence of metal reacted must be equal to number of gram equivalence of oxygen produced. How do you find number of gram equivalence? Same, weight of metal reacted, weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal equal to weight of oxygen displaced or produced or liberated by equivalent weight of oxygen. What is the equivalent weight of oxygen? You can write if you are interested. So weight of oxygen displaced in grams by, of course, in grams, equivalent weight of oxygen is 8. If this volume is given, if this is expressed in volume, volume of oxygen liberated at STP in liters by equivalent weight. This must be expressed in volume. At STP, what is the equivalent weight of oxygen? 8. At STP, 8 grams of oxygen occupy how much volume? 5.6 liters. So, you can cross multiply this, what I will get? Equivalent weight of metal is equal to weight of metal reacted by weight of oxygen produced displaced into equivalent weight of oxygen. Equivalent weight of oxygen. Which is equal to weight of metal reacted by displaced, they must be in same units, into 8. Suppose if I want to write in terms of volume, just cross multiply, what I will get? Weight of metal reacted, these two, now you have to take these two. By volume of oxygen displaced in liters at STP into 5.6. In the same way, you can write for chlorine. Chlorine displacement method. Metal reacts with a substance, produces chlorine. Metal reacts with a substance produces chlorine, then it becomes chlorine displacement method. So mass of the metal will be given in the problem. Chlorine, it is a gas, its mass can be given or volume can be given. So same thing, instead of oxygen you will get chlorine. So if I write for chlorine in a similar way, chlorine displacement method, chlorine displacement method. So instead of oxygen, what we get? Chlorine gas. So its mass can be given or volume can be given. So equivalent weight of metal reacted, same applying law of gram equivalence, metal weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal by equal to weight of chlorine displaced by equivalent weight of chlorine. What is equivalent weight of chlorine? 35.5. So equivalent weight of chlorine is 35.5. If this is expressed in volume, then it becomes volume of chlorine displaced at STP in liters, volume of chlorine displaced at STP in liters, the equivalent weight of chlorine is 35.5. At STP, 35.5 grams of chlorine occupy how much volume? 11.2 liters. So this must be written as 11.2. So here, instead of oxygen, you will get chlorine. This is nothing but 35.5. If it is expressed in volume, it becomes 11.2. So this is hydrogen displacement method, oxygen displacement method, chlorine displacement method. So the next method is metal reacts with a substance. So the metal may form metal hydride or metal oxide metal hydroxide metal carbonate metal sulfate, metal nitrate, etc. It can be anything, metal chloride also. So what information they will give? Mass of metal and they will give mass of the product. Same thing, apply gram, number of gram equivalence, principle of number of gram equivalence for reactants and products. So if metal reacts with substance and forms metal hydride, then what happens? So this is the equation, weight of metal reacted, I am taking the first one, weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal, this is for reactant, this information will be given, we have to find equivalent weight of metal reacted will be given. Metal hydride, if I take the first one, weight of metal hydride form. By equivalent weight of metal hydride. In this, the information, the mass of metal reacted will be given, the mass of metal hydride formed will be given. So let us write at the same place. What we get here is, okay. So what I can write here is weight of metal hydride formed, this will be given by weight of metal reacted, this also will be given equal to what? Weight of metal reacted is equal to what? Equivalent weight of metal hydride by equivalent weight of metal. No, see here, metal hydride, metal carries positive charge, hydride carries negative charge. So in the case of anionic compounds like this, already we have studied in the case of salt, equivalent weight of salt equal to equivalent weight of cationic part plus equivalent weight of anionic part. So what can I write here? Metal hydride means metal and hydrogen. So I can write like this, equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of hydrogen. What is equivalent weight of metal? We don't know. Let us assume E. Equivalent weight of hydrogen is 1. Equivalent weight, we assumed it as E. These two will be given in the numericals problem, right? So you can find, solve for E. Right. Let us see the next one. Metal reacts with a substance and forms metal oxide. Metal reacts with a substance and forms metal oxide. So, mass of metal oxide will be given, mass of metal will be given. So, again, I am applying a number principle of gram equivalence. Number of gram equivalence of metal reacted must be equal to number of gram equivalence of metal oxide formed. Number of gram equivalence of metal oxide formed. So, I will write here for metal oxide one more time. So, here what I can write? Weight of metal oxide formed by equivalent weight of metal oxide equal to weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal. Number of gram equivalence of products equal to number of gram equivalence of reactants. You can write either way. So, I am just writing the information that will be provided. Weight of metal oxide form, this will be given by weight of metal reacted equal to equivalent weight of metal oxide by equivalent weight of metal. Now, same story, metal oxide, metal plus oxygen. So, what I can write here? Equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of oxygen by equivalent weight of metal. What I will get? Let us assume equivalent weight of metal as E, equivalent weight of oxygen is 8 by E. These two will be given, you can solve it for E. Suppose if metal reacts with a substance and forms a metal hydroxide, then what happens? So, instead of metal hydride, you have to write metal hydroxide. Metal hydroxide. Right. Metal hydroxide. Metal reacts with a substance and forms metal hydroxide. So, this is what we get. So, cross multiply. Instead of metal hydride, you have to write metal hydroxide. Here you have to write metal hydroxide form. So, metal hydroxide, metal plus hydroxide ion. Hydroxide means OH minus hydroxide ion. 16 plus 1, 17. 17 by charge 1. So, equivalent weight will be 17. Formula weight by charge on the ion. What is the formula weight? Sum of the atomic weights. Atomic weight of oxygen 16. Atomic weight of hydrogen 1. 16 plus 1, 17. So, this is the formula weight by charge on the ion. Negative charge, you have to take magnitude, that is 1. 17 by 1 is 17. So, E plus 17 by E. E plus 17 by E. So, if it forms metal carbonate, then what? Same thing. Metal reacts with substance and forms a metal carbonate. Metal carbonate. So, what I would write? Weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal equal to weight of metal carbonate formed. Weight of metal carbonate formed by equivalent weight of carbonate. Carbonate right? Cross multiply. So instead of hydroxide, you will get metal carbonate. Weight of metal carbonate formed by weight of metal reacted equal to equivalent weight of metal carbonate by equivalent weight of metal. So once again, same story, equivalent weight of cationic part, that is metal, plus equivalent weight of anionic part, that is carbonate. Equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of carbonate ion. Then what is carbonate? CO3 minus 2. CO3 minus 2. So formula weight, nothing but sum of the atomic weights. 1 carbon 1 into 12, 3 oxygen, atomic weight of oxygen 16, 3 into 16, 48, you will get 60. So its formula weight is 60. I am finding its equivalent weight. By charge, magnitude of the charge, that is 2, 60 by 2 is 30. So instead of 17 here, you will get 30. E plus 30 by E. E plus 30 by E. Right, the next one, you can write metal nitrate, metal chloride, any substance, right, the procedure will be same. Metal reacts with a substance and forms metal sulfate, then what happens? So weight of metal will be given, weight of metal sulfate will be given, applying number of, sorry, principle of Gram equivalence, weight of metal reacted by equivalent weight of metal by weight of metal sulfate formed. By equivalent weight of metal sulfate. So cross multiplying, because these two will be given, I am writing at one side, weight of metal sulfate formed by weight of metal reacted equal to equivalent weight of metal sulfate formed by equivalent weight of metal. So same story, equivalent weight of metal plus equivalent weight of sulfate ion. Sulfate ion is nothing but SO4 minus 2. So how to find sulfate ion equivalent weight? SO4 minus 2. Sulfur atomic weight 32, 4 into 16, 64. So how much I will get? 96. So atomic formula weight by charge on the ion, that is 2. So what I will get is 2, 4 is 8, 2 is 16. So E plus 48 by E.